Today, I have chosen a different topic, that is the governor. And in governor, I will discuss a few points. I have noted down the points. How the pilot power is balanced. And what how the zero setting in the pump is done, and what should be the maximum fuel rate, and what should be the maximum angle of the lever from the governor, and the accumulator spring setting, and the servo piston spring setting. RPM of the governor is very high. Why is that? Because it will depend upon the centrifugal force of the flywheels. These two are the flywheels, this and this, and this is the rod which is connected to the pilot valve. So the sensitivity of the governor, it will depend upon the centrifugal force generated out of the rotating flywheels by R, the centrifugal force of the flywheels. So the variable is the mainly the variable is V. R is changing by only a small amount. So if we can change the velocity with the velocity of the flywheels, that means the angular velocity of the flywheels with respect to the engine rotation, then the sensitivity will be better. That is why the governor gear is matched with the engine gears in such a way that the governor wheels then rotate in a very high RPM. Okay, and coming to the next point, that is how the pilot valve is balanced, how the pilot valve is to be designed. Because if it is a simple one, a problem is faced. The dotted lines, they represent the pressure, pressurized oil. So now what we can see, the pilot valve is under pressure from the pump. So it is natural that the pilot valve will come down due to the force acting from the top. So even if the RPM is maintained, then also the pilot valve is coming and it is continuously giving oil to the servo piston or servo cylinder. So it is not wanted, and a design has to be made in such a way that the pilot valve is maintained at a position which will keep the this port to the servo cylinder closed at the times when the RPM is maintained. That means we have to create one force which is opposite to the downward force. That means we have to create a upward force which will be cancelling the downward force. One more annular ring is created on this side which will keep the pilot valve pressed in the upward direction and which thus cancels the downward force due to the area here. And so when the RPM is maintained, this will maintain the pilot valve in the closed position at all times when the RPM is maintained. One more point is how the maximum travel of the governor shaft is to be maintained. That means this is the lever which controls the fuel lever attached to the fuel pumps. This is the governor here, this is the fuel pump. So this is the fuel rack and now let's assume that the governor has given the maximum fuel to the fuel pump and it can be easily seen that if the fuel pump rack is maximum before the full travel of the lever of the governor, then during the time which the governor is further trying to move the fuel pump rack, it might break, it might damage the rack or the connections. So an arrangement has to be made in which the travel of this lever is restricted and stopped before the end of the rack is reached, so that there is still some travel left which is free to move and thus the end of the rack is never reached. And in that way we can protect the rack from damage of the governor lever movement. So this is one more setting. Let's say the governor is position of the governor, that means the governor is not working, that means the engine at idle position, and this is the angle of the arm, and if this is not matched with the zero position of the fuel pumps, let's say this is matching with the if this is not matching with the zero position, the zero position of the governor and the zero position of the fuel pump rack must match. The zero position of the fuel pump and zero position of the governor must match, or even we can say that at zero position of the governor, fuel pump rack must be even lower than the zero position of the injection, zero position of the pumping. Otherwise, when the if the governor has reached the zero position for at the zero travel, and in that condition, if the fuel pump is still at some value of fuel, then that fuel will be going into the engine and the engine will not stop. So that is the reason these two must be synchronized. This is the gear pump taking oil from the sump. Here what we can see is that the pump discharge side there is an accumulator which maintains the constant pressure in the discharge side. This is the accumulator. With a spring loaded piston. And here is the relief valve which maintains the constant pressure, and during the time when the oil is not being consumed, the oil is going back to the sump again. This is